Welcome back to On the Hook, the places, faces, and tales of Myrtle Beach Seafood. I'm Dylan, and I'm here with the places, faces, and tales, Jeff Martini, owner of Midtown Bistro and Bar 1912.
Hi, I'm Dylan Foster, and I love seafood. I've been in the Myrtle Beach area for more than 15 years, and since then, my life has revolved around seafood. From cooking and catching it, to serving and selling it, I've done just about everything you can do in this industry. So come and join me as we tour the places, faces, and tales of Myrtle Beach Seafood. This is On the Hook.
You are a fisherman.
Yes, sir.
Right? You're a chef, you're a restaurateur, and more importantly, most importantly, you are a fisherman as well. You actually go out on your own boat, the Dirty Martini, right?
Yes, sir. Dirty Martini.
And what are you doing out there? You're fishing, you're diving. Tell me about what you do out there.
We do a lot out there. We do trolling for wahoo, mahi, and yellowfin tuna. We do a lot of deep dropping between 700, 900 feet for snowy grouper, your favorite yellow grouper.
I love it.
And golden tile, which is some of my favorite.
All right.
And then we'll come in and drop down about 120 feet. We dive nitrox and we shoot our own hognose snapper. We shoot our own scamps and gags. And we also catch our lobsters. And our lobsters are big in the Carolinas.
These here spiny lobsters.
Up to 10 pounds, the monsters.
Yeah. So when you say you're diving, you're going down, how deep are you going?
Between 1 and 120.
100 and 125 feet, that's where you're getting your lionfish, that's where you're getting your hog snapper, your hogfish.
Yep.
Man, and also scamps and gags.
Oh, yes.
So you can't dive for the yellow edge and the snowy grouper, right? They're
deep,
a little deep.
Too deep for us.
A little 700 feet too deep for
too deep for us.
So what are we cooking today? What are we going to cook today?
We're going to do a little scamp today, scamp grouper.
All right.
We're going to franchise it, a little flour egg wash.
Okay.
Pan saute, sherry lemon butter sauce, and finish it over a little angel hair pasta tonight.
A little classic dish, but done right.
Classic.
That's what you guys do here at Midtown Bistro.
Yeah.
You take the classics, put your own spin on them, and just do them right from start to finish.
Keep it simple.
All right, Chef, so tell me, we have some scamp grouper here. You guys check that out. Straight from the source, this guy caught this fish, shot this fish, right? This is what you go for.
Shot that fish.
And it's scamp grouper. So scamp grouper, make sure you like and subscribe our other videos, and check out when we cut scamp grouper from another captain in Merle's Inlet down in our shop. Scamp grouper is a really great fish with a small flake, thin flake, great.
Delicious.
Great to cook in a pan like we're gonna do today. So delicious. What are we gonna cook?
We'll take a little bit of oil first.
Okay.
We're gonna get us going over here. We'll chop up a little onion.
All right, what do you need me to do? I got some vegetables over here too.
You can chop up some vegetables, that'll be the side dish.
How do you want these? You want these diced, you want these?
Sure, yeah, you can julienne style.
You got it.
I'll get us some garlic and onions. That's my starter on everything possible.
Me too. I love garlic and onions.
Oh,
I put it in everything.
So good. So
put
good.
Put it in everything.
And while that's going,
okay,
we're going to go ahead and grab our grouper and dredge it up like this.
I got your garlic here.
You got the garlic.
I love this pan.
Oh, that's a great pan.
This is a great heavy bottom. That is a cast iron. I mean, this pan weighs it's got to weigh 10 pounds. I mean, this is a heavy pan.
She's old. Dylan, if you want to throw a little oil on
there. Yes, sir, right here.
And
here you go. A little more?
Yes, sir. We'll get some up front here.
I love it. That coating on that scale on that fish, it's just gonna hold all that moisture in. It's gonna be nice and golden brown and crispy. Awesome. Awesome. Garlic's looking real good over here, Chef. Midtown Bistro, they do some of the best food here in North Myrtle Beach. Italian, fresh seafood, these guys do it all. In go the onions. Loving it.
If you wanna grab us a little sherry.
A little sherry right here.
Get these going here for
you. Tell me when, Chef. Get some of our red peppers julienned up here for our side. So this grouper, look at that. Look at the color here. Oh, that nice crust there. Look at that color. Looking great.
Give me a little chicken stock up there, sir. Little secret ingredient
secret
over
ingredient.
Here.
Secret ingredient. Shh, don't tell. They'll all be doing it. And you guys should smell this. It's getting, that onion and garlic in that pan is just smelling beautiful right now. Cherry going in. Ooh, watch out, you're in the splash zone here. Oh man, that smell, it's just so aromatic. It just smells awesome. Beautiful. That fish is gonna be so nice, so juicy. that crust nice and golden brown. I'm looking forward to this. Flambé. Chilly this morning. Now this franchise, this grouper franchise, is this a dish that's on your menu?
This is a dish on our menu. This is the first dish my father taught me when I was a kid, and it's a classic. We're gonna go with a little butter.
A little butter in the pan? Can't go wrong with butter.
Oh.
That is the good stuff. So earlier you were telling me about Big Rock. You just got back from a fishing tournament in North Carolina.
Blue Marlin tournament, biggest one on the East Coast right now.
The biggest tournament on the East Coast.
Yeah,
all right.
Money too. It's over $5 million in the pot.
Wow.
It's nice. We ended up grabbing a 350 to 400 pounder. Released them.
Woo.
It was a great day. Really great day.
So when you're on the hook with a 300, 400 pound marlin, how long does that take to reel in? What does that look like?
1 hour. My son was on it. So they dance in the water going crazy.
It's
a big high.
Man, I have heard some stories about marlin fishing, but I have never had the opportunity to do it. Hey, make sure you hit that comment down below. Have you ever been marlin fishing or in a big fishing tournament? We'd love to hear your stories. We'd love to hear it. Show us a picture. We'd like to see the fish, the biggest catch. We have a little cornstarch, a little slurry going in here.
A little slurry.
All right, we're gonna thicken that up, bind that sauce up.
Sure.
So you were not alone in the Big Rock tournament. There's some big names that fished that tournament.
Fish next to Michael Jordan.
Yeah, Michael Jordan, huh?
Big compliment.
The GOAT himself.
Yes, man.
Not just from the free throw line, huh?
No. He's from the... Now he's a cigar smoker. He is a cigar.
Cigar smoking, marlin fishing, Michael Jordan. Yep. I love it.
Ain't getting no better than that.
Yeah. So you mentioned your son. You fish a lot with your son?
That's what we do.
Is it, you just have one son, yes?
One son, one daughter.
One son, one daughter. Does your daughter get out on the boat with you?
Every once in a while.
Yeah?
Yep, she's a nurse, so she's kind of
God bless her heart.
Yes.
It's got to be cool to be able to share that experience with your children, with your son. To be out on the water fishing, just enjoying the beauty of the world.
It's all about family and friends, man.
There you go. All right, so the fish is now going in to our stock. We have our sherry, we have our chicken stock, onions and garlic, and now that nice golden brown scamp grouper, local scamp grouper, caught by yours truly, chef and owner Jeff Martini.
Sir, we're just gonna let that simmer for a little while.
All right, set it and forget it.
Set it and forget it. We'll do a little angel hair pasta.
Okay.
And we're gonna be ready to eat.
I'm loving it. We're getting hungry. It is smelling so good. So good. I wish you guys could smell it. Waft that out your way, maybe you get a little whiff. All right, what about our side dish here? We still have some vegetables to cut.
Yeah, let's chop up a little vegetables.
All right. Do some of this squash and zucchini over here.
Pretty cool here at Midtown Bistro and Bar 1912. We have a garden out back. So we basically grow our own tomatoes, banana peppers.
Really?
Yes, sir.
We're going to have to go check that
basil,
out.
Basil, scallions, mint for all our cocktails. You know, we try to keep everything as fresh as it is.
And that's what's nice about you as the chef here at Midtown and Bar 1912. You really give the respect your ingredients deserve.
True
respect. From the seafood to the vegetables to your herbs, you're really doing it the right way. And that's not easy to do in today's world.
No.
Everybody's about more volume and more volume.
Yeah, everybody wants to do more and more and more.
You have a quality, not quantity,
yes, sir,
kind of mentality, right? So
yes,
you're going to come, you might spend a little bit longer here at the table, but you're going to have an absolutely phenomenal experience. Are your vegetables, chef, coming from a local vendor?
Yeah, we actually have A&A Produce that we use.
Okay.
We're local.
Yeah, that's a great company, A&A Produce down there. So Andy's done a great job.
Yeah, Andy's a good guy, man. Good guy. Good guy.
Born and raised local man. Another great family man.
Yes, sir.
Sharing his tradition with his family.
Yes, sir. That's what you can do in the Carolinas.
It's all about family. All about family. Or whatever your local fishermen are bringing in, yes?
We do a local fish special every night.
Every night you're changing it?
Every night we change the special. And then our other items on the menu, we have a fat-injected pork chop that's unbelievable.
Ooh.
We've got filet mignon, we've got a ribeye, but then we've got your classic veal parmesan, fettuccine alfredo, spaghetti and meatballs, chicken piccata. So we venture all over at a decent price. It's not a high, extensive price.
Good food done right at a price that you can afford.
Yep.
I love it. And it sounds like there's something for the entire family.
Everything.
Temping it out? What temperature are we looking for, chef? Gotta get the glasses on.
Yes, sir. We're only at 100. We got a
little ways to go. Gotta check it, make sure it's the right temp. All right.
A little frost of hair for the boys. We'll
little angel hair down in the bowl. I love it.
We'll make a couple plates here in a minute.
Well, we got the hungry Kyle and Christian are back there. They're smelling this just like we are. They're getting hungry.
You could just touch it and it falls apart.
Oh, man, look at that. That golden brown fried crust is now soggy because it's been into that franchise sauce. Oh, man. The flavor, the smell. I can't wait to taste this.
It's like butter.
Oh, boy.
Finished
fresh basil from the garden.
Basil.
I love it.
Yes, sir.
Homemade, homegrown basil, fresh from the garden. He does it all here. Jeff Martini, he's a jack of all trades. He's doing it everything. Ready to go. Man, this is going to be good. We've got that beautiful scamp grouper with that golden brown breading there, that angel hair, and that sauce. Look at, can you see how tender that is? Just, I mean, that is just falling apart. Here we go. Chef.
Delish.
Oh, man. Yes. Knock that one out of the park. That grouper is nice and soft and buttery, got a hint of that sweetness. That sauce is just warm. It warms you. It's good, good, wholesome food, man. It just brings you back. Man, chef, nice work. I mean, that is amazing. Guys, don't forget to come on in here to Midtown Bistro. Come and see Chef Jeff for your own self. See what he's catching that day. See what he's cooking that day. And have yourself an amazing meal here at Midtown Bistro. Chef, it was a pleasure. Don't forget to like and subscribe those videos. Check us out on the hook where we visit more places, faces, and hear their tales of your Myrtle Beach seafood. I'm Dylan. We'll see you guys next time. This is so good, Chef. Oh, man.
Beach easy.